laser screwdriver, we'd have Sonic.
Guys, and welcome back to another prop replica review. Today's replica is the Masters Laser Screwdriver by Collingwood Replicas, and this was used by John Sim in Series 3 and Series 10 of Doctor Who. So, this is a one-off prop. It was made by Collingwood Replicas, and because it's a one-off, it doesn't come with a box or a stand or anything like that. It's just the prop that he's made. I've even just got it propped up on the Millennium Effects stand for the sake of this review. So there's really no box or anything to look at for that reason. So let's just dive straight in then. So starting at the bottom, we have this lovely brass end cap piece here. That's just one solid piece. It's not like, say, the 11th Doctor Sonic Screwdriver. There's no special button hidden in this Sonic Screwdriver. Sorry, this laser screwdriver. It's just one solid piece, and that's the same for these two bits as well. This bit looks like a nut or a bolt, kind of almost looks like it should be able to turn, but it doesn't. It's just one piece. That being said, this lovely part here does turn, and this in the show is what the Master uses to change the settings on the screwdriver if he wants to turn the Doctor old or if he wants to inhibit his regenerative ability, which for some reason makes him really small. That's what the Master uses. And what I particularly like about this little piece is that it's crackle painted. So it's painted just like the 10th and the 9th Doctor Sonic Screwdriver, which I think kind of links the two props really well and kind of reflects upon them being from the same era of Doctor Who, which I think is really, really cool. So yeah, other than that, not much else to say about that end piece. It's really nice and sturdy, and I'm a big fan. So moving on to the main body of the laser screwdriver, what we get is fair more bits of brass. So we have brass here, brass here, brass here, and more brass inside here, which I imagine this area is kind of like where the Master would check his readings and such. And that is sort of housed by this grated aluminium section here that has a similar pattern to the Series 5 11th Doctor Sonic Screwdriver. And that's basically a grip for the Master to hold when he uses the laser screwdriver. Other than that, we have this little emitter button that's housed around the back here, and that's what activates the lights on this prop. But yeah, that's the central section of the screwdriver. What I like about this is kind of how minimalist it is. It doesn't really go overboard with stylized things or patterns or anything like that. It's really functional, and it does kind of look quite villainous as well, which reflects the Master's character really nicely. So that's the central body. Up from there, we have the top section and the emitter. And that again is a mixture of aluminium parts and brass parts here, with a few grub screws put in there for good measure to keep everything in place. When you look at the screwdriver in its closed position, that's basically what you get, and nothing else reveals itself until we open it. So what I want you to do now is I want you to look at this section, which is the brass, and this section here, which is the aluminium on the top, because these both open separately when the laser screwdriver is pressed. So pressing that now, there we go. We've got the brass section in here, the sort of central channel almost, kind of reminds me of the glass bit on the 10th and 9th Doctor Sonic. And then we have these little rods that have opened to allow the emitter heads to come even further out from the prop. And what that leaves us with is an absolutely enormous prop now, probably bigger. It is in fact bigger than the 12th Doctor Sonic, just as big as the 11th Doctor Sonic, and as heavy as them both for sure. So let's move on to the light that this prop has. Obviously the prop has no sound because sound is added in post-production, but when we press the small micro switch on the side here, we get the three LEDs in the top that light up a lovely orange colour, and we also get lights inside the core of the Sonic Screwdriver as well, which is really nice because it kind of reminds me almost of the 13th Doctor Sonic Screwdriver. It feels like the whole prop kind of comes alive when those buttons are pressed and something's going on in there that's going to make the laser screwdriver shoot whoever the intended target is, whether it's Cybermen or Martha Jones's family. But that's a really nice feature that has been put in there for this prop, and it really adds to the overall look and feel of it, which is fantastic. But how exactly does this prop differ from the toy? Well, let's take a little look here. Let me just lodge that up. Here is the toy version of the Sonic screwdriver, and you can see there how it's slightly smaller and the materials that have been used on the original kind of just speak for themselves. There's not a lot more to say about that, but I'll just hold it above there for a couple more seconds so you can compare it yourself. Obviously, main differences that you can't see are the weight. The actual prop is so much heavier than the toy, and it has a real sort of weight to it, which is fantastic. And of course, unlike the toy, you can control both the separate sections of the open and house. So you can close that bit if you wanted to, but you don't have to close those three rods. It's up to you if you want to close them again, like the Master's laser screwdriver. So yeah, that's basically what you get with this prop. It's a fantastic prop. I'm really, really in love with it, to be honest with you. And I love the materials and the style and the functionality of this piece. It's really, really great. It's a fantastic replica. And so yeah, leave a comment below. Do you like this prop? Does it do the job for you? Do you prefer a more Sonic style or a laser style? Which one would you choose? But yeah, other than that, that brings this little video to a close. Thanks very much for watching, and goodbye.